Welcome to Tentative Title with Tim. This is a podcast about creativity, about process, about filmmaking, and about screenwriting. Welcome, everybody, back to the podcast. And welcome, everybody, to 2022. Happy New Year, everybody. We made it. We're here in another year. And now is the time. If you haven't done it already, something I like to do at, you know, the last couple weeks of, the year is to kind of assess what it is I want to accomplish going into the next year. And it's a time of hope. It's a time of renewal. It's a time to reset your priorities. You know, like sometimes maybe you had an idea of a goal that you wanted to accomplish, and by the end of the year, it just didn't work out, or it wasn't actually what you wanted to do. And that's okay. You can change what it is you're going for whenever you want. That is the freedom of being an artist. That's the freedom of being a creative person. That's just freedom in general. Obviously, there are some stipulations to that. If you have a contract, if you have given your word that you're going to do something, clearly that is, you know, people are relying on you. Obviously, you have to follow that through. But at this point in time, if it's a goal that you've just kind of like kept close to the chest and you're trying to, it just didn't work out, that's fine. You can always reset. And that's what I wanted to kind of talk about today, is that now that we're in the new year, it's time to think about the next 12 months and what it is you want to accomplish. And it's the perfect time to really, a lot of people say that, like, when you make a resolution, people give up by March. And you got to think about it, that it's probably true. A lot of people go into the new year, they got all this fervor, they got all this motivation, they got all this drive, because it's the time to reset, and they go at it hard. They go at their goal, they're like, I'm going to make it, I'm going to do this finally, it's been like 5 years that I've said I'm going to do it, and now I'm finally going to do it, and then they peter out 3 months in. And I don't want to say don't come into the new year with like this like fervor, this drive, this passion to accomplish your goals, because that is helpful. But we got to understand that once we get into it, once that excitement about making a change is done, we still have to stick to that goal, right? We still have to focus on what it is we are trying to accomplish. And I know this episode is probably more useful for down the line, you know, like maybe in March, where I can be like, hey, you know, remember those goals? We got to keep going. But I think it's proper to talk about having a mindset at the beginning of the year where, you know, you look at it not as a race, but as a marathon, and being ready for things to go wrong, being ready for days when you don't feel like it, being ready for just any number of distractions that are going to pop up. Like, I mean, year after year, it changes where I think I can do this. It's going to be fine. I'm not going to get distracted. And then maybe a couple weeks in or a month in, I get really distracted. I get really discouraged. I don't feel like I can make it. I don't feel like the goals that I set for myself are actually going to happen. And I want to kind of set, I guess, the runway for understanding that things are going to happen in our lives that are going to disrupt any plans that we try to make. Like, no matter what, no matter if it's a small plan, no matter if it's something where you're like, I'm going to wake up an hour earlier this year, more likely you are going to run into, like, maybe the first day you're able to do it and you feel really good about yourself. But then the next day it's going to get harder. And then the next day it's going to get a little bit harder. And then the next day, maybe a little bit more, you know, and then, but if you stick to it, if you understand that there are going to be challenges, there are going to be things that are going to go wrong, then you're more likely to reach that goal. And that's what I want for each one of you, is that whatever goal you set for this year, that by the end of 2022, you can look back and say, yeah, there were challenges, there were things that went wrong, there were unexpected events that happened, but I still stuck to it. I changed where I needed to, and I still got it done. I still accomplished what I wanted to accomplish. And this year for me feels very, very positive, that I got a ton of things that I have on my list, on my docket, that I'm just like, yes, this is the year where I finally accomplished them, where, you know, because like the past years, it was kind of like building, or it was like planning, or, you know, it's like I put them together later on in the year, but I won't see the fruit of that, of what I planned, until like on into like this year. And so it's, you know, as much as I, you know, I came out of last year and I was just like, I did accomplish a lot. I feel like I accomplished a lot of things, but I'm not able to share a lot of it because I'm like, well, it's not done yet. It's like, it's not going to be done until this year. And that's been very frustrating, because I wanted to close out the year being able to share some things, being able to, like, you know, talk about the work that I've been doing behind the scenes. But I can't. I can't talk about that yet, because it's not done. And until it's, like, I don't like talking about things until I have something to show. And that's the frustration about being, you know, an artist, about being somebody who's creative, is that when somebody asks, like, what it is you're working on, it's like, I don't really want to talk about it until I can, like, pull out my phone and say, look, here's something I got, or, like, you know, here's a website you can go to, or here's, like, you know, here's the finished product. Because, you know, you can have a lot of things happening, you know, a lot of things that you plan for, but until they actually are finished, it's really discouraging to talk about, because people really want to see it. Like, if you talk about something, they're like, oh, that's great, can I see it? And then if you have to say, well, it's not done yet, then it's like, okay, that kind of, you know, all that excitement about what you're making sometimes gets stifled because of the fact that, like, it's not done. And so over the years, I've found that, like, if I just kind of, you know, keep doing stuff behind the scenes, and then when things are ready, I can, like, say, okay, it's time to make it public, it's time to put it out into the world, then it's a lot more exciting, because there's something to show, there's something to talk about. And then you can talk about the process, and then you can talk about, you know, the struggles, and you can talk about all these things. But it's very difficult to do if all there is just, like, you know, just a bunch of notes, or, you know, a bunch of versions of scripts, or like a draft of a novel or something. Like, it's really hard to talk about things when there's nothing to kind of, like, you know, show and talk about. And so this year for me feels like a year in which I can finally show what I've been working on, that I can finally put things out that, you know, I feel like I've put a lot of work into, that I've been stressing over for a very long time, that I'm, you know, it's been in the works for a long time. And it's really hard to kind of go year after year without really having, you know, quote unquote, like, a win. So, you know, if this year is a year of planning, that's fine. That, you know, use this year to plan, use this year to develop things, to write, to, you know, put things together. And maybe you don't, like, you know, if you're shooting a movie, maybe you don't shoot a movie until next year. That's fine. You know, or, like, if you don't start shooting a movie until later this year, that's fine. You know, it's just keep going. Being quiet, being, you know, like, putting your head down and doing the work, like, it's going to pay off. And, you know, sometimes it takes a couple years before that actually happens. And so I want to encourage all of you going into 2022 that whatever it is you're working on, don't be discouraged. Like, it's going to take drafts. It's going to take, you know, shooting some more scenes. It's going to take, like, maybe doing a few more shorts until you're able to do that feature. Like, just keep going at it. Keep your nose to the grindstone, as they say. Like, just keep working your craft, keep learning. And, you know, the best that can happen coming out of 2022 is that you say, you know, maybe I didn't accomplish like all my goals, but at least I got, you know, you have a list of a few things that you got done, a few things that you accomplished, a few things that you learned, you know, that stepped out of your comfort zone and you got to see like what it was like to, you know, whatever, like what it was like to write a novel, what it was like to, you know, write a screenplay, what it was like to be a director or a DP or an actor, whatever it was in your creative field, in what you were trying to accomplish, that you can look back and say, you know, I at least had one thing that I did that was that was progressing me forward, that was giving me momentum to what it is that I really, really want to do with my life. Because we are very, very lucky as creative people to just do what we do. Not a lot of people have that choice. And in fact, creative people like have to make compromises all the time. We have to, you know, like we have a vision in our head of what we would like to happen. And more often than not, it doesn't happen. And more often than not, the thing that we absolutely hate is the thing that the general public is going to love. And that's just, I guess, the curse of being a creative person, is that, you know, you want to do so much with the talent that you have, and sometimes it's not appreciated until later on, or you know, like it doesn't quite hit in the way that you want it to. And, you know, that's fine. Like, the art is alive. Art, it, you know, goes through phases. It grows, and as people, you know, look at the things that you make, maybe at first they don't like it, but then over time they come back to it and they're like, actually, you had something very, very, you know, insightful about, you know, just whatever subject you're focusing on. You know, just be ready for things to not work out, you know, but you got to keep going. And understanding that, like, problems are going to arise and you just got to keep going. So I wanted to kind of keep this very short because, you know, if you're listening to me, maybe you're not writing that script, or you're not, you know, planning that shoot that you're supposed to be on, or whatever. So I just want to keep it short. I want to give encouragement. I want to say, hey, we're in a new year. It's a time to reset. It's a time to, like, to really go after it and to treat it like a marathon and not as a race, because, you know, you want to be, to be fair, you want to be an old woman doing this, and the way to do that is by treating it as, like, you know, you're not trying to get this done in a couple years, it's a lifestyle. You're going to be doing this until the day you die, because it's something that we can't help but do. It's like, it's in us to create, and we're going to do that as long as we have breath, as long as our hearts are beating. We are going to be creative people. We're going to find ways to express ourselves. And that is a lifelong endeavor. It's never going to stop. And that is wonderful. That is a great, I guess, you know, commission, drive, purpose that we have, is to just create and to share and to you know, bring joy to other people, and you know, like, hopefully we can have an audience in which, you know, they love what we do and they want to see more, and they want to support us and want to make sure that we can keep going. and the people who love art, who love the process of creating, like they're out there. They wanna see more stuff. They wanna see you succeed. And all you gotta do sometimes is ask. All you gotta do is just put something together that is like from your heart, that's personal, and it's going to find its way. It may not be immediate. It may not be like, you know, within a month or a year of when you put it out into the world, but you know, eventually somebody's going to find it. They're going to love it and they're going to share it. And that's all we can hope for. And then your audience is going to grow, and it's going to take time. It's going to take years. It's going to take a long, like it's a lifetime of just, of, you know, creating things for people. And that is the joy that I'm finding year after year, is like just making things that people can just say, wow, thank you for making that. That was awesome. When are you going to make something else? Please make something else. You know, that is the excitement. That is the joy of being a creative person. And, you know, don't be discouraged. So, I know this episode talked about a lot of stuff, but it's just encouragement, encouragement, encouragement. Keep going. You know, we can still, all of us can do it. We can just take time out every day to create something, to work on something, to move that, you know, move towards that goal that you've set for yourself. And I want to see it, like whatever it is, like send it to me, send me a link, send me something that I can look at and say, wow, this is somebody who listens to this podcast and look what they created. Oh my gosh, that's amazing. Like create more stuff, just keep going, because it's very exciting to see when people step out and you know, create something cool. I love that stuff. I can't express it enough that I love seeing cool stuff that people come up with. So, all right, guys, that's all I got for today. Go into the new year. Let's make some awesome pieces. You know, like if it's novels, if it's screenplays, if it's films, if it's comic books, whatever it is, if it's a painting, you know, if it's poetry, whatever it is, just go out there and make it. You know, it's from your heart. It's from your experience. It's from you, and the world needs to see it. All right, guys, I will talk to you on the next one. If you'd like to connect with me, there is an email for the podcast. It's tentative.title.with.tim.podcast@gmail.com. There is also a Twitter account. The handle is @title_tim. There is also a Facebook page where you can post questions, or you can connect with me there. Thank you guys for listening. I'll talk to you on the next one.